Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play gaming video of Train Simulator 2021. And today, I'm going to be driving the class 460 from Gatwick Airport to London Waterloo in the evening on this occasion. And without further ado, let's jump in the cab and let's get started. Right folks, it's now time to get started and let's head towards Gatwick Airport as we are leaving the train yard just south of the airport. So I do now remember how to set up the train correctly, as you know. It's been a long time since I've used this Class 460, but as you know, I like to drive electric trains as well as diesels in Train Simulator 2021, and this train is quite different to get started, but if you follow the procedure like I've just shown in the video, it's quite easy to get going once you know what to do. Okay, but anyway folks, let's continue our journey, and as always I do appreciate all feedback, and I hope you will enjoy this journey with me as well. Okay then, we do have about 5 minutes before departure, so we are quite early. What I'm going to do, I'm going to try and work out how to get this GSMR set up, as we are doing the one Unicorn 04, I believe, all the way to London, Victoria. I'm just going to check the schedule just to see if the code is there. But if not, I'll just guess it. Okay then, our code is 1 unicorn 21 for this service, and I'm just going to set that up now. Okay then folks, I hope I've done that correctly. As you know, I don't usually touch the GSMR radio or the GPS, whatever it's called, but as you know, I just play the train simulators and I'm definitely not a professional at all. But if I have this correct, the 1 unicorn 21 is displaying on the screen, so as far as I'm aware, all is grand and that's set up ready to go, and we will be departing soon once we get the road. Okay then, folks, we are coming up to an 80 mile an hour speed limit. So I'm just going to use a wee bit of braking just to bring our speed down, okay? And once we clear the zone, I will put the power back on so we can go back up to 90 miles an hour. As I was saying there, folks, I will put the power back on once we are clear of the 80 mile an hour zone. Unfortunately, the train simulator was just loading tiles, and I'm not sure if the microphone was recording, as the recorder does pause automatically as and when the game loads tiles and trains and stuff. As you can see, folks, we do have, as I was saying, we do have a 60 mile an hour speed limit coming up, and we're just outside Croydon, not too far away from it anyways, so we will have to go through all the low speed limits, and then we should be on our way towards London Victoria, which isn't too far from here, as you know. I do like this route, but I'm gonna make my own scenario for this Class 460, as I do plan to use the airline liveries that are available for this train. So that's another project. However, I do plan to make a Class 170 scenario based on the Southwest Trains day, in the days of Southwest Trains. But I just need to find out where the Southwest Trains Class 170s would call from, so that I do get the stops correct for that scenario I plan to make for the Portsmouth Direct Line anyways. So I will do a let's play of that once I get the scenario made up, so that's something to look forward to as well. I'm just going to use a bit more braking, folks, as we are coming to some low speed limits and I want to be ready for them. Because although I have the career mode scoring turned off, as it does detract from the realism, I do try to drive properly to the best that I can. Although I'm not a professional and I'm definitely not a train driver by any means, so I just drive to the best of my ability, as well as try and drive these trains properly, you know. As you can see there as well, folks, I didn't sound the horn on that occasion. The reasons being, I wasn't going through the station that fast, and I was doing less than 30 miles an hour, just in case I have to stop for a signal for some reason. So, use of the horn there wouldn't be really necessary. However, I usually do sound the horn when I'm going much faster, you know. Likewise, we are now back in the 60 mile an hour zone, so I'm going to open up the power to 100% just to get our speed back up. As you know, our next checkpoint will be Balham, and I believe that could be just before Clapham Junction, which we will be passing through. As I was saying there, Clapham Junction will be after Balham, where we will be passing through at a moderate speed, I'm assuming, as we are on the fast tracks, you know. I have to admit, folks, I do find the horn, which I am using here, just to warn passengers to keep back, as you know. In my opinion, it does sound like a cross between a Class 47, or it could even be a Class 442 horn, as it does sound similar to them as well. Although, to be honest with you folks, to be utmost honest and truthful, I can't remember what the horns actually sound like on these trains, or at least on the real things, as I was under the impression they'd be similar to something like a Class 180 or even a Class 170 in the real world. But to me, the horn sounds like a mixture of a Class 47 and a Class 442, from what I have heard on YouTube videos. Anyways, best start slowing down, folks. Okay then, folks, I believe the next signal could be a danger. I have no idea, but I'm bringing the speed down so that I can take appropriate action if necessary. Okay, as you know, just like the real life Clapham Junction, it is a very busy station, so I'm just going to reduce my speed down to about 15 or even 10 miles an hour, just to make sure that I'm not going to cause a spad or pass the signal at danger. So I just want a visual, and that's just the AWS going off there, which I've just acknowledged, folks. Anyways, we've got a caution, which is a single yellow, so I'm just going to continue at a cautionary speed so that I can stop if necessary. Okay. Anyway, we've got a double yellow, folks, so I'm still going to drive at no more than 30 miles an hour. But anyways, we're not too far away now from London, Victoria, and that will be where this Let's Play will finish. Right, folks, I do hope you have enjoyed that, well, this Let's Play. As you know, I haven't really driven the Class 460 for a long time, and it is nice to do something different. I thought I'd explain the procedure about sounding the horn when passing the signal of danger. Again, from what some of my friends that drive these trains for real in the real world tell me, the reason for that is to let the guard know that the train is passing a signal with authority, a danger, or something like that. The rules may have changed since then, but that was about 2001, 2002, before he retired from the railway. But anyways, that's another story. So I thought I'd explain my reasons why I did that long horn when passing that signal with authority at danger. Anyway, folks, that's all for now. Thank you for watching if you made it this far. But until next time, folks, have a great week or weekend. Take care, all the best, and God bless. I'll see you later, and I'll catch you in another Let's Play coming soon. Okay? Cheerio, folks, and all the best.